imagine somebody running with a gun behind my father just so that he's dead.
On 31st July 1985, Lalit Makan and his wife Gitanjali were killed at their home in Kirtinagar, New Delhi.
How old were you when your parents passed away?
So you can say 6. My birthday was on 10th August. Ek din gaadi aayi and I got up ki papa aa gaye and I realized papa nahi aaya and he cannot come.
On the 25th of February 1995, Sister Rani Maria, a 41-year-old nun from Kerala, was stabbed to death near the town of Udayanagar in Madhya Pradesh. On 26th November 2008, 10 members of Lashkar-e-Toyba carried out a series of coordinated shooting and bombing attacks in Mumbai. The terrorists claimed 164 lives.
She said, "Your husband and daughter were both shot and killed in the restaurant." And I couldn't believe it. I said, "Both of them?"
When we killed Makan, I think he was hit 8 or 9 times on the first shot. But still he woke up. We thought that we are not successful. So we have to take the bigger weapon, stun gun. Then he was hit with 28 bullets. There was an eye for an eye.
मैंने था तो सिस्टर के ऊपर हमला कर दिया चाकू से हमला कर दिया और एक वार कर दिया दो कर दिया फिर इसके बाद में क्या आदमी को खून सवार हो जाता फिर वो एक लक्ष्य हो जाता जब तक इंसान मर नहीं जाता छोड़ कर दिया
We just kept staring at whatever information we could get and that's when I saw for the first time the face of Ajmal Kasab, this young man holding the gun at the train station.
कितना शूट किया तुमने पता नहीं बस ऐसे चलाते रहे बस चलाते रहे और होता था जब तक जिंदा रहो मार
I'm not much of a speaker really, but you all saw the trailer of a documentary film that I made and released recently on in India in January. And so it's a film about three killings. I'm not sure, probably many of you might not have watched it. There isn't much of a documentary viewing kind of habit in India, but that's something we are striving to change. So, ये डॉक्यूमेंट्री जो मैंने बनाई है ये एक्चुअली तीन हत्याओं के बारे में है और इसमें तीन कहानियां हैं 1980 के दशक में 90 के दशक में और 2000 के दशक में और तीनों कहानियों में ऐसा होता है कि जो मारने वाला है उसके साथ क्या होता है आगे उसके परिवार पर क्या गुजरती है जिनकी हत्याएं होती हैं उनके परिवार पर क्या गुजरता है और आखिरकार दो कहानियों में जब हत्या करने वाला इंसान और जिन परिवारों के सदस्यों की हत्या उसने की है उनकी जब मुलाकात होती है तो क्या होता है सो द फिल्म ट्रेसेस द स्टोरी ऑफ थ्री मर्डर्स थ्री वायलेंट किलिंग्स इन द 80s 90s एंड 2000s ईच ऑफ देम विद अ काइंड ऑफ सोशियो पॉलिटिकल बैकग्राउंड एंड इट लुक्स एट व्हाट हैपेंस टू द families of the perpetrators and the perpetrator himself because unfortunately or whatever in all three cases they are male perpetrators and what happens to the families of those who are killed or to the person and to the people and ultimately in two cases what happens when the perpetrator meets the family members of those he has killed and No, it's not a murder mystery and it's not a thriller really. It is an exploration of love and forgiveness. And I was kind of, my journey in making this film has been really rough in many ways. I was working on a television show called Satyamev Jayate. Maybe some of you have watched it and know about it. And it dealt with some very serious social issues. I was very fortunate to head the field research for Satyamev Jayate, and I traveled across the country for around 4 years, almost non-stop, listening to stories of courage, change, struggle, violence, and so much else. And at the end of my Satyamev Jayate journey, I was in a state of churn. To Satyamev Jayate, shayad aap logon ne suna hoga ya dekha hoga. और चार साल तक मैंने उस पर काम किया. बहुत सारी कहानियाँ सामने आईं और बहुत मुश्किलों का सामना करते हुए मैंने लोगों को देखा. और उस सारी चीज़ों को देखने के बाद मेरे अंदर एक बहुत बड़ी दुविधा आन पड़ी थी. मेरी मनस्थिति ऐसी बनी थी कि इतना सारा कुछ है दुनिया में जो गलत है. और एज एन इंडिविजुअल आई वॉज अबाउट टू टर्न 50. तो मेरी उम्र 50 साल होने वाली थी और मैंने सोचा कि एट द एज ऑफ 50, विच इज काइंड ऑफ लाइक अ माइलस्टोन और अ लैंडमार्क, व्हाट इज इट दैट आई वांट टू कंट्रीब्यूट टू द वर्ल्ड इन द रेस्ट ऑफ द इयर्स दैट आई हैव विद मी. आने वाली मेरी जितनी भी जिंदगी बची है, आई हैव मोर बिहाइंड मी देन आई हैव अहेड ऑफ मी. व्हाट डू आई रियली वॉन्ट टू डू. एंड इट इज अ टाइम दैट वी लिव इन टूडे दैट देर इज वायलेंस ऑल अराउंड. देर इज अ काइंड ऑफ स्पाइरलिंग sense of retribution and revenge, and there is a never-ending spiral where people seek revenge for something that happened 1,000 years ago or even more. We don't even know actually what happened and who did what to whom, and yet we seek revenge and retribution in that name. So, ऐसा ही है कि ये सिलसिला कि कब किसी ने हजारों साल पहले खून किया था या कुछ हुआ था उसके लिए आज हमें revenge चाहिए, आज हमें किसी का खून चाहिए. तो ये चीज़ें देखते देखते मैं बहुत ज़्यादा डिस्टर्ब हो रही थी और मुझे ऐसा लग रहा था कि आगे क्या किया जाए. एंड अराउंड द सेम टाइम इन माय पर्सनल लाइफ आई हैव टू कन्फेस दैट आई वाज फेस्ड विद अ वेरी डिफिकल्ट सिचुएशन वेयर आई वाज वेरी एंग्री विद अ पर्सन. आई वाज वेरी एंग्री एंड दैट पर्सन हैड हार्म्ड समवन सो क्लोज टू मी दैट इट वाज वर्स पेन देन समवन हैविंग हार्म्ड मी. And I was seeking revenge. I was on that path of, you know, plotting. What should I do? So, इसी दौरान जब सत्यम जयते खत्म हुआ था, मैं सोच रही थी कि दुनिया बर्बाद हो रही है. Like अभी तो गाने के प्रोग्राम में भी जाकर लोग गोलियां बरसा रहे हैं. Like कुछ भी चीज अब sanctity किसी चीज की नहीं रही. इंसान की जिंदगी की कीमत भी नहीं रही. उसी समय मेरी जिंदगी में एक दुविधा ये थी कि मुझे बहुत गुस्सा था किसी पर. किसी ने कुछ किया था मेरे एक अजीज से. और मैं प्लॉट कर रही थी कि मैं प्लान कर रही थी कि मैं इसका रिवेंज कैसे लूं. और उसी समय मुझे एक इन इस फिल्म में जो तीन कहानियां हैं उन कहानियों में से एक कहानी के बारे में मैंने थोड़ा सा पढ़ा. आई रेड अबाउट इट वॉज एट दैट टाइम दैट आई रेड अबाउट वन ऑफ द स्टोरीज इन माई फिल्म. इट अपियर्ड इन अ न्यूज़पेपर एंड आई डिडंट बिलीव वन बिट ऑफ इट. आई फेल्ट दैट इट वॉज फिक्शन. आई फेल्ट दैट इट वॉज कंप्लीटली एग्जैजरेटेड एंड मेड अप. एंड आई रियली वॉन्टेड टू गेट टू द बॉटम ऑफ इट लाइक अ ट्रू जर्नलिस्ट. So I went out and started meeting people. I met the people and I discovered to my utter delight and shock that actually it was completely true. So mujhe laga ki ye mujhe maine padha in kahaniyon ke bare mein ek kahani ke bare mein aur mujhe laga ki ye galat hoga. Ye isme sachchai ho nahi sakti ki kisi ke mata pita ko murder kiya aur usne us bande ko jaakar maaf kar diya hatyare ko. Lekin jab maine tehqeeqat ki to mujhe pata chala ki ye sach hai. So once I realized that there was a truth in it, I was driven kind of by a force and I said that these are the stories that I want to now tell. And I started exploring and researching and I discovered that there were so many stories of forgiveness all around us. It's just that the stories of revenge, retribution and hate get highlighted both in fiction and in reality. And the innate, the innate goodness that is within all of us, just as much as the innate evil, I believe, is in all of us. It's all about what you are going to feed. Are you going to feed the evil or are you going to feed the goodness? And when I started exploring these stories and I started meeting these people, things kind of started falling in place and I started the research interviews. People agreed to give me time. And I had to, at that point, I had to come to a deep realization about myself. And I had to realize and say that, Swati, there is a deep innate evil within you and you seem to be feeding it right now. So you better decide which way you want to go. And जैसे मैं इन लोगों से मिलना मैंने मिलना शुरू किया मैं उनके साथ बैठी और एक दिमाग में कीड़ा था अच्छा अभी आप एक हत्यारे के साथ बात करने वाले हो यू नो तो यू गोइंग टू बी सिटिंग फेस टू फेस विद अ मर्डरर एंड यू नो दैट काइंड ऑफ वॉयरिज्म दैट यू नो आई हैव टू कन्फेस दैट आई फेल्ट दैट बट जैसे ही मैं हमारी बातचीत होने लगी एंड ओवर अ कपल ऑफ सेशंस You realize that but for a quirk of fate, it could have been you in that position instead of him or her. So everyone, even a person who has committed murder, shows you their humanity if you give them an opportunity to. And that's exactly what happened with me. So, jaise main interviews karne lagi, unke saath maine samay bitaya, mujhe ye ehsaas hua ki ek ghatna uske haath se ho gayi hai aur uske kuch karan hai. लेकिन ये इंसान भी इंसान है और गलती मुझसे भी हो सकती थी आपसे भी हो सकती थी हम में से किसी से भी हो सकती थी तो धीरे धीरे ये चीज़ें मेरी समझ में आने लगी और आखिरकार ये फिल्म बन गई है फिल्म द फिल्म हैज़ बिन रिलीज्ड एंड आई बिन वेरी फॉर्चुनेट दैट वी फर्स्ट रिलीज्ड इट ऑन टेलीविजन सो वी रिसीव्ड अ प्रीटी हेल्दी व्यूअरशिप ऑफ अबाउट 32 मिलियन यू नो ऑन टेलीकास्ट Yeah, and that's the reason we went to TV first and not to a channel like Netflix, which is a little restrictive for India. So after the film is released, there have been, of course, the reviews and all of that. But immediately, what has been happening is that almost every day I get letters or emails or calls and messages from people saying that. They have been personally impacted by the story of forgiveness and they are at multiple levels many people take the whole the story of the film very personally and it's something that they are seeing as creating a certain space within you which gives you some time to think about things a little differently from the way otherwise is the norm So it's very heartening when people write to say, so a gentleman wrote recently saying that I have decided to forgive the doctor who I hold responsible for the death of my 20-year-old daughter. He was negligent and I've been holding on to it for a long time, but I've decided to forgive him and let go. Or there was a journalist who actually started crying while interviewing me and I said, like, what's going on? And she said that my brother was killed in an accident and it was a drunk driver. I have never forgiven that man. So, and now I'm interviewing you and I've watched the film and I feel that, you know, I have to let go. So, मैं कहना चाहती थी कि ये फिल्म तो मतलब क्षमा की ताकत पर है और इसको देखने के बाद लाइक बहुत सारे लोगों का रिएक्शन आते रहता है कि उन्होंने कैसे अपने पर्सनल लेवल पर वो क्षमा को देख रहे हैं क्षमा के बारे में सोचने का एक मौका या एक जगह मिलती है हमारे दिमाग में हमेशा बदला लो कि किसी ने एक मारा तुम दो मारो तो उससे हटकर एक जगह आपको मिल रही है चीज़ों को देखने के लिए और सोचने के लिए तो अभी ये जो है पावर ऑफ वन यानी कि एक की ताकत तो मुझे लगता है कि ये नहीं है कि ये मैं एक बट मैं कह रही हूँ कि एक के साथ एक यानी कि अ वन ऑन वन तो या एक फिल्म या एक कम्युनिकेशन पीस की ताकत होती है कि वन ऑन वन आपसे रूबरू हो सके एक कम्युनिकेशन एक इंसान से और इस तरह से हम हज़ारों इंसानों तक पहुँच सकते हैं हम कम्युनिकेशन के द्वारा हम कहानियों के द्वारा तो मेरी यही कोशिश है आगे चलते हुए कि कुछ ऐसी कहानियाँ बताने की मैं कोशिश करती रहूँ मुझे ताकत मिलती रहे कि मैं कहानियाँ लोगों की आप औरों तक पहुँचा सकूँ जिससे शायद कुछ फ़र्क पड़े और मैं बहुत एक्साइटेड हूँ इस चीज़ के बारे में कि अब खुद ब खुद बहुत सारे लोग अप्रोच कर रहे हैं और अलग अलग संस्थाओं में स्क्रीनिंग्स की बात हो रही है. तो ये फिल्म तो अभी इंग्लिश और मल्टीपल लैंग्वेजेस में है, लेकिन इसका डबिंग हिंदी, मराठी, बंगाली, तमिल, तेलुगु और मलयालम में भी हो चुका है. तो अगर कहीं पे कम्युनिटी स्क्रीनिंग्स कोई भी करना चाहे तो प्लीज़ मुझे कांटेक्ट कीजिए, इफ़ एनीबडी वुड लाइक टू डू. अभी जो जुवेनाइल होम्स हैं जहाँ पर चिल्ड्रन हु आर इन और यंग पीपल हु आर इन कॉन्फ्लिक्ट विद द लॉ, उनके लिए बॉम्बे में एक स्क्रीनिंग होगा अगले महीने. उसके बाद हम एक डिस्कशन रखने वाले हैं फिल्म के बारे में कि, और अच्छा, अच्छी बात यह है कि हमने कोशिश की है कि कोई एक्सपर्ट इस फिल्म में नहीं है. जिन पे बीती है वो उनकी आप बीती वो खुद बता रहे हैं. सो वी ट्राइड हार्ड नॉट टू प्रीच बट टू अलाउ पीपल टू हैव देयर ओन एंड टेल देयर ओन स्टोरी थ्रू दिस फिल्म. या सो दैट्स प्रीटी मच इट एंड आई होप आई बीन कोहेरेंट.
I'm just picking up on that one point where you mentioned that when you got to speak to the perpetrators over a period of time, you see the humanity in them. Could you just, maybe elaborate a little bit more? Because for the rest of the world, any perpetrators always, one, it's very black and white, and sometimes one is accused of maybe sympathizing. So a little bit more in the humanity aspect which you saw through your conversations with them.
Yeah, so actually for me it was a process. I started exactly from that point of view of seeing a human being through the label that we put on him or her, and that label happens to be stuck onto you because of one incident sometimes. That one incident defines your whole life. But as you as I spent time with them, the vulnerability with which they opened up and the depth that to which they have thought about what has happened to them and the kind of loss that you see within them because of what they have done, irrespective of whether or not they have regret for what has happened, but that incident has damaged them. And you cannot help but feel that there are two parts to this person: the person who has that part which has caused damage, but also the part that has been damaged. So we as a society, which part do we want to focus on fixing? Because right now punishment is all about trying to fix that part which did the wrong, but we are not trying to see the part that has also been wronged, and where is it taking us as a society? So, and some of the small things that they would share with me, it started me thinking, gosh, I could have also gone down that path. I mean, I could have fallen for that trap. So it's that way that because you start seeing, at least I saw, reflections of my own psyche in many of the things that they were saying. So if I consider myself human and I'm sharing some thoughts and psyche with them, then they are also human, right? So that way.
ट्रेलर देख के दिल दहल गया एंड आई कैन अंडरस्टैंड वॉट यू मस्ट हैव एक्सपीरियंस वाइल लिसनिंग टू दैम. इट ऑल्सो गॉट मी थिंकिंग, हैव यू वॉच्ड द मूवी जोकर?
जोकर?
या
नॉट येट.
सो आई गॉट इन टू अ डिस्कशन अबाउट हाउ वैंडलिज्म, बिकॉज वन पर्सन और वन सेक्शन ऑफ द सोसाइटी हैज बीन रॉन्ग्ड अगेंस्ट द सिस्टम, वेदर द मास मर्डर्स आर जस्टिफाइड एंड वेदर द वैंडलिज्म इज जस्टिफाइड. And there too, we talk about empathy and forgiveness, because empathy is key, and that's where forgiveness stems from. So how does one really know where to draw the line? Where do you really draw the line? Can we go ahead and convince more such individual people who have been wronged to be able to forgive somebody who's wronged them?
So here's the thing. I feel that, firstly, I haven't watched Joker, but I can guess what you're saying about vandalism and where to draw the line. Each of us has to figure out for ourselves where we want to draw the line. We have to also have some consciousness and a desire to question that this line of action so far, I mean, what is the line, what is the major line of action so far? If you are wronged, you hit back. Am I right? eye for an eye, tooth for a tooth, nail for a nail, life for a life, right? Where has it taken us as a society? I'm really asking all of us to question that. And then we have to, like, we are so good at balance sheets. Many of you are in the corporate world here. So in the social, emotional balance sheet, are we in a loss or are we in a profit as a society by this line of action? So we really need to have conversations about that. The second thing you said is, how do we convince people to forgive? We never convince people to forgive is what I feel. I think we have to allow people to have access to thought processes of different kinds. We are pretty much fed on a mono diet right now. I even say this about documentary, by the way, that we are so much fed on a mono diet of Bollywood fiction and popish, movies, that there's no space for documentary, and then we say that the audience doesn't like it. But the truth is, if you feed a child only chips from the moment they are born, then they are not going to develop a taste for any other food, right? So likewise with forgiveness and ideas of this nature, I feel that we have to allow them to, I mean, even for me, it was a new thing. I'm confessing that I was on the path of revenge, and my film actually, the process of making the film really redeemed me and saved me from a really terrible fate, I think. So each of us have to be allowed to have that space. I don't think we can or should or have the right to convince anyone who's been wronged to take path A or path B. But we do have the option of opening up certain choices before them at any rate.
Just to thank you for that last point, because that's exactly, because we are trying to talk about how do we move back and move away from what we see is extreme criminalization. Or, for example, if there's rape, then the only punishment is capital punishment. And we're saying, no, let's do away with capital punishment. Let's talk about how do we look at restorative justice, as both Aparna and I were talking about, and how do we look at different processes. I mean, the other case that came to my mind, and I think Renu from Ali would completely empathize, is an acid attack on which Ali has been working, in which the woman's life, she was 17 when acid was thrown on her, and it's been, I don't know how many years, 2000, the acid was thrown on her, and we're in 2019, 20 years. And the man went to jail for 20 days, and then he's married, he has a child, and the case carries on.
Are you referring to Lakshmi's case?
It's a Kanpur case. It's
okay,
not,
it's a Kanpur case.
I'll not name.
Yeah. But it's similar.
Yeah.
I mean,
so yeah. Now, what do we do with that? And obviously, if I turn around and talk to her about forgiveness, that's not going to happen. And his wife writes to Ali and says, what about my rights? And Ali is like, let's think about what we're doing here. What do we talk about when we say restoration, when we say rehabilitation, when we say truth and reconciliation? What do we mean by it? What does that language contain? And I really appreciate your saying that, you know, we can't have a line, and we need to think about different processes, and we need to think about penology as a science. Like, what punishment to what crime, and how does that work out? And is it only law, is it social justice in a different way? So just thank you so much for bringing those nuances into the conversation.
Thank you.
Thank you. Svati, before you leave, I want to ask you about what idea you're working on now.
Oh, thank you so much for asking me that. Do you mind if I answer that question in Hindi?
Whatever is comfortable to you, I'll translate.
No, because one of the people I'm actually collaborating with is sitting right here, and I really want to make this, which is Ashif Ji. So, yes. Okay, I'll make it in both languages and very quick. What is justice? What is the idea of justice? And what is the idea of justice, let's say, for a survivor of rape or sexual assault? Is it about that judgment from the judge, from the court, which is in her favor, which is the favorable judgment? Or is it something else? And can we as a society reimagine the concept of justice itself? So I am working on a film along with Ashif Ji's organization, Jan Sahas, as a start point for the research. And we'll be reaching out to many other people, as many as we can along the way, looking at different kinds of violence gendered violence, and the response to it that is coming from the ground. So we do have the violence that women are facing. There is a violence against women. And what are women and men as well doing as a reaction to that violence, which is actually extremely restorative in nature. तो होता क्या है कि बलात्कार के बाद ऐसा लगता है कि हमें न्याय चाहिए, न्याय चाहिए. इवन भवरी जी ने बोला कि न्याय मनो न्याय चाहिए. बट सवाल ये है कि जो क्या न्याय की एक ही परिभाषा है? आपने कहा नहीं, अलग अलग लोगों के लिए न्याय की परिभाषा अलग है. तो क्या हम न्याय की परिभाषा को इस तरह से बदल सकते हैं कि जिससे हम पनिशमेंट से ज़्यादा हम चीज़ों को फिर से ठीक करने की बात करें, रिस्टोर करने की बात करें? तो मुझे ऐसा लगता है, आई फील दैट द काइंड ऑफ वर्क दैट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन लाइक जनसाहस हैज बिन डूइंग, एंड आई हैव हैड सम फैंटास्टिक प्रिलिमिनरी इंटरव्यूज विद वुमेन एंड मैन इन मध्य प्रदेश. आई हैड बिन देयर फॉर अ 5-day विजिट, आई ओपनर, एंड वेयर यू सॉ देम इन द डिग्निटी मैच. नाउ दोज वुमेन हैव गॉन वे अहेड इन, सो आई थिंक दैट रेप एज अ क्राइम काइंड ऑफ destroys you at a certain level, and then you need regeneration. So they have regenerated themselves, they are in a process of regenerating themselves and other people as well. And there are conversations, there are deep conversations that are taking place, because what happens with intimacy, what happens in a family, what happens between husband and wife, how do you rebuild those? It's not about the police thana alone. So I'm working on a film of this kind. And we have been speaking not only to survivors of rape, though they are our primary focus, but we have also started speaking to perpetrators of rape. And we are trying to have that conversation with compassion, Ashif ji, ki hum unse sahanubhuti nahi, lekin hum unko samajhne ki koshish karte hue perpetrator se baat karein. To hamari ek perpetrator se mulaqat hui thi, for example, ek ladka in Madhya Pradesh, and he gave us a fine interview, and we spoke about how did he understand sexuality. No one ever taught him. Did he have any exposure to sex education? No, he did not. Did he understand the concept of consent only after he went to jail? And what is his exposure to intimacy and sex? It's from watching what he calls sexy videos with his friends. And can I really blame him for the fact that the only exposure that he had to intimacy and sex was through sexy videos, which are actually violent pornographic videos? So can we view our perpetrators with compassion as well? Can we create a space where we can also see that what is destroyed within him can also be restored? And rather than polarize the conversation between is it death penalty or not, do we forgive or not, I think that if we start trying to find a little bridge to understanding each other better, maybe we can make some sense of this terrible, terrible situation we find ourselves trapped in. Because I feel like that trap every single day, every single moment. And I'm also putting out an appeal for all kinds of help. We're looking to raise funds to make our film. We've of course started, we are not stopping, and we are making it partly with whatever resources that Ashif ji and Jansa has have very generously brought to the table, partly through my own personal savings. And we've moved on and we've moved ahead, because there is no time to waste. And you know, we are looking out for partners and collaborators in this journey. So anybody who wishes to have a conversation, I would welcome it very much. And thank you very much for allowing me to ramble on.